Hi guys, it's Sammy.
Hey, it's Sophie.
Hey, it's Stephanie.
And we're Sammy.
Sophie.
Stephanie.
Welcome to our channel.
Today we're going to be doing, since we really slacked on March favorites, we're going to do both March and April today.
Mixed together. Okay, so my first favorite is GOT7, Never Ever. Let's try it. Let's sign it. A bop, a bop, a bop. That's all I have to say.
One of my favorites is Oh My God, Thanks by Matt Cow.
Oh God. Oh my god, thanks!
Literally, like, 3 out of the 10 are matching.
Okay, one of my favorites was. Beautiful by Monsta X. Cause, like, she just took me. It was in the title, Beautiful, but what else?
Like, I also had Monsta X Beautiful.
Should I just go ahead and say Monsta X Beautiful too?
Yeah, because that way you put it for all three of us.
It's on my list too. It's a good ass song. If you haven't checked it out, go check it out.
Another song that was my favorite in March and April because of the Wings tour that I did not go to. BTS is Not Today. Like when was that the opening song?
Yeah, it was.
Like, it was so powerful. I watch live streams because, like, I'm a big fan like that. But, goodness gracious, that song is so powerful. And, like, it just, like, it makes you want to start a movement in a music video.
Another song that I really liked for March and April was Highlights, Please Don't Be Sad. Like, it's telling me not to be sad because it makes me happy. It's a really good song.
My third is YOLO by Madtown.
YOLO,
YODO,
IDIO, IDIO, na 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 na
na na na na na na. Like, it speaks for itself. It's a good song.
Another one that I really, really liked, mainly because of March and that whole tour of madness, Shiny World, Doo-Bop version. But like still, like if they're going to change
Shiny
the set list.
World. They didn't sing Shiny World at Shiny World. What the fuck?
Doobop doobop.
My next song is Another by Monsta X. I was about to sing it and then I forgot how it started. Ready or not. Ready or not. Are you ready or not? Can you delete that? Like, I know how the song goes. I just didn't
are
have the
ready
first
or
notes.
Not?
No, but what the hell? The song is really, really good. Like, honestly, like, it's on par with the title. It's really, really, I've lost words. Just go. Like, I can't speak English.
My fourth song is another one by Matt Town.
Just call it Mad Town.
Why did you look at me like that? I just look over at you, she's like. No, but why did you look at
me? No, I was like, because I thought you were mad at me, because I said just call it Mad Town Faves.
I mean, basically, but. This is a more slower song. I think it's their recent comeback. I haven't looked at their video, but I really like this song.
Another shiny favorite, because it wouldn't be a Steffi fave without shiny faves, is Excuse me, miss, I'll hit your yes, no, no, yeah, please, romantic dance, Excuse me, miss, because I went and looked back at like shiny
Chris Brown.
It's an excellent Chris Brown song. That Chris Brown song, I will not judge you for humming. But it's also a really fun SHINee performance, and I like watched it a bunch after SHINee World 5 in Dallas because they did not perform it. Even though they changed the set list for North America, they did not include that. But it's a really fun performance, and Jungkook is extra, and that is pretty cool.
My next song is again by Monsta X. Okay, so basically she had a Madtown playlist, she had a SHINee, mine is Monsta X. It's Calm Down. Which, funnily enough, like, I thought about putting OI, but I think Calm Down is a little more underrated, but it's also a bop. Like, Jukyeon in the chorus saying, calm down, calm down, really gets me. It just gets me in the feels. It just gets me in the ovaries, and I just think it's a bop. Done.
Calm down.
It sounds better with calm. Trust her.
Calm down.
It sounds a lot better by Monsta X.
Okay, my number, what is it, 6?
5.
This song also includes like a funny like word. It's called Dosa by SHINee. At one part, you just hear Minho in the back, he's like, whatever. And it's the funniest thing, and honestly, aside from that, it's like a really good song. Like baby making song.
But like Minho does ad lib throughout the entire song, so I actually did not catch that because okay, I blocked him out after the like 15th ad lib. Chung de la Koto Joe
like me. Whatever.
Bye for the song was an NCT 127 song, and I was not expecting to really rock with NCT 127. I was like, NCT U is the only NCT I recognize. But then I actually listened to the mini album. And these past 2 months, the song that I've been paying attention to a lot was Baby Don't Like. My baby don't like it when you come around. If for nothing else, the bed squeaks in it.
I haven't heard it.
It's yeah, there are bed squeaks.
But it's just like, they say my baby
don't like it when you come around.
And then there's bed squeaking. And I'm just like, alright.
So what does that mean, NCT? What does that mean?
My next song is Really Really by Winner. Cause it took me by surprise. It's a summer bop. I mean, who doesn't like that song? If you don't like it, you're questioning it.
That was one of my faves as well.
The way she said that as well.
My number 6 song is What Am I to You by History. They do like this little move, and it's like the most hilarious thing ever, and they still look sexy. Go check it out.
My next one. Now, it's very rare that you're gonna catch me apologizing for my opinion. But if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And when we first reacted to Rookie by Red Velvet, I freaking hated it. In fact, I was like, second, third, fourth listen, I'm not gonna like it. I lied to myself and I liked it. Because it's a bop. I would actually say that like Automatic, Dum Dum, Rookie, like top 3 Red Velvet songs of all time. That's how much I like Rookie. That's how much it is. It's a bop. It's like, first of all, the verses going up to the chorus, like the vocals, and then the ad-libs by Folgy and Wendy, even though I don't like her, like you gotta give it to them. It's a bop. No.
I think it's the music video. When you watch the music video and listen to the song for the first time,
it's too much.
It's like such a good song.
My number 7 is gonna be Let's go. Doom Dada by Top. I recently listened to it for the first time like a month ago.
Wow.
And I was shook. I really like that song.
Really.
MV is questionable though. Like, what is going on?
Art.
But it's still iconic.
Okay, my number 7 is another BTS babe. Danger. For some reason, like, I watched American Hustle Live and then I just did not keep up with BTS after that for some reason. So I didn't really catch Danger when it came out, but then I like re-listened to Danger after they came to the US and I didn't go to see them. And it's a bop, TBH.
My next one is, so, you know when you download songs and you don't expect to like repeat them? This is what happened to me with the song. So we reacted to CLC Hobgoblin and I was like, they're trying to be 4 minutes and whatever they're trying to be, the song is a bop. Like, it's like all of a sudden I see myself doing their choreo, I'm on the treadmill and I'm just feeling it. It's a bop. It's really catchy. It'll get you going while you're working out.
I'll go along with the CLC train, but mine is called I Mean That. It's in the same album. It's a little slower, but it's really cute song. I didn't really think I would like CLC, but I do, and I'm actually here for them, so I can't wait. I haven't even listened to the rest of the album, but I think I should.
Me too.
Another song I really like, this is the last SHINee / BTS one. If you can't tell, that was the March half.
Wow.
It's Interlude Wings. And like, I guess it's like a pretty like whatever song in the like scope of themes. It's not like
I love that song.
Super revolutionary or anything, but it's just so much fun and it just makes me feel good. Like, it's just like instant mood boost, just.
I love that song.
Me too.
It's a feel good song.
Yeah. It sure is.
And not in like the fake way, but like it like genuinely just makes me feel good.
Exactly.
Whether you like it or not, you're gonna feel.
So this song for me, because we literally just reacted to it last week and I've only listened to it like 5 times a day, is SF9's Easy Love. It's like the beat is just like. Do you remember it?
Yeah. I like that move.
I know. Honestly, like, I just feel like SF9 has shown such a progression, like, because we listened to War, and then they had, what was the other one?
The first one was Fanfare.
Fanfare.
I wasn't a huge fan of that one.
Yeah.
Roar caught my attention.
And then now we're at Easy Love, and I see y'all step into the plate. You're like, I see you're in love with Monsta X, and you're just trying to, you know, and I'm here. I love it.
And number 9 is called Buku Buku by MSTY. I don't know if that's how it's pronounced. I've never heard of them before, and my friend showed me this because Rap Monster is in it, and I love the song. I don't really like the beginning, but I like the rest of the song.
Buka Buka. That sounds like Buka.
What's Buka?
It's a Nigerian student of my mom.
Is it good?
Really good.
I have been listening to a lot of playlists and like kind of trying to get into working out, so I've been listening to a lot more girl groups, and one girl group that kind of took me by surprise was WJSN. Like, I'm literally this is just their name on like Spotify, because I probably watched their music videos and I was like meh, but like listening to their songs, so many girl groups have like really bopping beats. This one is Secret. They just have that like feel good, go about your day, magical girl aesthetic to their entire like music, videos, everything, and it just covers me.
Is this the same? Cause
Cosmic Girl.
The funny thing is that I saw a BuzzFeed article that there was some K-pop fan that said that two of the members were lesbian,
yeah,
a lesbian couple from China, and everyone ended up falling for it. And that they were like the most richest people in China, and they married each other. So there was a lesbian couple.
That was like
that was really
dead.
Yeah.
My final song is. What? K-pop sexy moments that I did not recognize my bae went on. Literally, I didn't recognize
me.
That's how drunk I was. But, love you, Meek. Love that song. Oh.
My last one is Never Ever by GOT7. Third, I don't think it needs explanation. It's just a really
song. Okay, and my last one is another girl who's they're actually from VAP's company, and they debuted right when VAP went on strike, so everyone hated them. I wasn't really feeling it. Yeah, Sonamu. And they have like a cutesy song. So of course I just skipped that music video, but it came up on Shuffle and the song is called I Like You Too Much. It's like a pretty cool balance of like cutesy and like sassy. Sort of like in that like Mamamoo lane.
That sounds like
that,
even the name sounds similar.
I just, how could you not have got that sooner?
These were top 10 for the past March and April. Let us know what your top 5 were for each month in the comments below.
And don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.
Thanks.
Bye guys.